Okay. Okay, satu, dua, tiga, action. Okay, what is up guys? Fahan here with Zah once again. And we have our friend here, Rasul. Yes. The owner of this Yamaha MT-15. Okay, this is the first time I'm seeing this bike. And I have to say, I thought it's a class 2 at first.
Many people in the traffic light also asked, thought it was a class 2 bike. Doesn't look like 155cc.
So, what do you think, Zah?
Because one thing I like about the MT-15 is because the design of the headlamp. The headlamp, I really like the design.
Like Ghost Rider.
Like Ghost Rider.
That's right.
Once it open the switch on the light, like, you know, a skull.
Very fierce.
That's what you said just now lah. Okay. Okay, just give to you a bit background about your bike, the MT-15. MT-15.
Make the same mistake of R15.
So the MT-15 is a Street Fighter bike from the MT series. It was first launched in Thailand on October 2018 and is widely available in Asian markets. It's marketed as an affordable, no-frills commuter bike for the regular rider, and its main rival is the KTM Duke 125. Engine specs is a 155cc liquid-cooled single-cylinder 4-stroke SOHC with a 6-speed manual gearbox. The MT-15 shares its engine and components with the 3rd generation R15, which we reviewed on the previous video. Okay. So here in Singapore, it's a popular choice for Class 2B riders who love the bigger MT siblings but cannot afford one. I got no Class 2. Okay, so I just want to ask you, Rasul.
Yeah.
Why did you buy the MT-15 and how would you compare it with other Class 2B bikes out there?
Okay, so to rewind time back to 2019 September when I finished my Class 2B, I was actually, before that, I was not really a motorbike person. I don't know anything about motorbike. I don't know how the gear all works. So basically, I don't know anything about motorbikes. So it was just a random day. I came home and tell my dad I want to enroll a Class 2B, as I have Class 3 already. Just before I want to go inside NS, I just want to take and keep first lah. So the initial plan was just to take the license and just keep, not to buy a bike. So once I finish Class 2B, after the TP test, when we go to expressway, the expressway familiarization, right? The instructor asked, so which bike you guys want to buy? So he asked everyone, they had their bikes like RXZ, KR. And then when he asked me, I said I'm not so sure. So after that, the same day, I went on to maybe just take a look at the like popular bikes. So all I saw was KTM 200, KTM 125, I saw the R15, Honda CB 150R. I wanted to go for it, but then I didn't. Then after that, I saw this MT-15, and then I saw the front, which really made me fall in love with the bike. Look very fierce. I went to research more about the bike. Then I saw that this is the street version of Yamaha R15. That's the sports one.
The Street Fighter version.
Yeah. So after that, I told myself, okay, I'm going to get this bike. So my dad didn't want me to buy a bike because he said it was dangerous. So I show him the photo of this bike. I say I want to buy this bike. Then he look at it. He asked me, are you sure you want to buy this bike? It looks very big. And I told him, no, it's only 155cc. Even he was shocked. Yeah, so after that, he said, okay. Then after that, about 2 months later, I went to the bike shop. Then I saw this bike. I sit down on the bike. I just try. It was really, I really like the way that, even though it's tall, right? My legs are long, so I can like,
tiptoe.
Yeah, because after I bought the bike, some of my friends tried to sit down. They had to tiptoe. So I didn't have to tiptoe. So I thought, okay, this is the bike I'm gonna get. So I got it.
Hey Zah, I want to tell you, I want to ask you something. You are always interested in the MT series. So what do you make of it?
You know, one thing I like about the MT, the Yamaha MT series, they have like 15, 03, 05, 07, 09 and MT10. So it's like a whole range, a big family, you know. This one being the youngest of the all.
Don't MT tank sudah.
And then they have, I think in some other country they have the smaller version, MT125.
MT125?
Yeah, I've seen on Facebook, but I forgot which country. I think it's India.
India.
Yeah, and then for MT15 they have the gold fork. Gold Fork is from Thailand, I think, but mine is India version, the Silver Fork lah. So they are, so the difference actually is nothing much. It's just the this kill switch they in the Thailand, the Gold Fork version lah.
You know what can be made nicer is if this bike has inverted fork.
Inverted
yes,
fork.
Yes, the other one have.
If the inverted fork ah, very nice.
The Thai version lah.
It has a more
aggressive look.
Aggressive look, yes.
Yeah.
What do you love about your bike?
About this bike, I really love how I think the other day I researched. I researched and I remember that this is one of the most powerful Class 2B bikes below KTM 200, if I'm not wrong. Because I just saw a list, then I saw MT15 there, and together with the R15 and all lah. So at the traffic light, usually I see the only thing, like, you know, when the traffic light is red. Then it's green light, the only thing will go very fast first is probably a Super 4 or an Aerox, then followed by me. I like the way it picks up, it's really aggressive. You know, my pillion also sometimes tell me to, like, when I pick up or cool down. I try to cool down and slowly pick up, I still the same because my pillion BM will like pull back like that when it pick up. So it's really a very powerful bike.
So it's talky lah.
Yeah.
Very talky lah.
In your experience riding this bike, how do you would you describe the handling performance and performance of this bike?
Okay.
I know lah, this is your first bike lah, but maybe in your own words lah, how would you describe it? Because I think people who ride multiple bikes before, they'll probably like know the difference.
Yeah, I have ride also because I have rented a few bikes like Spark. Oh. Recently, I rode an Aerox and R15, V1, V2, all was rental lah.
So you rode more bikes than me, brother.
Because I was trying like different bikes lah. So
that's a cool thing, you know. That's a good thing to do.
You should have done that.
Before you actually buy a bike, you try out which bike you may feel for it, you know. But because during our time, there was no business that caters to rented bike.
Correct. Yeah.
Only quite recently, a few years back, the government passed
a law
that you can actually do rental bikes.
Rent bikes, yes. And not only that, you can also do food delivery on those bikes.
Continue.
As compared to I ride in the highway, it's actually not so shaky because you know some bike if you go above maybe a certain speed like 120, 130, you'll start to shake. This one I never felt like that. So, the highest I went accidentally at BKE going coming back here towards PIE, at night was empty traffic, so I just decided I mean after I go past the camera I just try max. I reached 140. 140, but then it was still very stable. I could have gone more, but then I decided not to take the risk lah.
140,
yeah.
Sure, 140.
For on a 2B,
Fair 140.
And on the other day,
impressive, you know.
Impressive, very.
The other day, I went out with my friends. I wore the action camera on my helmet, so I just looked down. Then I was a red light traffic going towards Marina Barrage, so it was empty. So once the light turned green, I tried to hit 0 to 100 in how many seconds. To my surprise, it was only 14 seconds. For Class 2B bike, I don't know is it a good or not, but I felt like it was quite fast lah.
Quite fast ah?
For 2B bike, to reach 140 is quite an impressive feat, you know. Because most of the 2B bike on the average would be about 120,
125,
slightly before 130.
But I know the two strokes bike they can go higher than 140.
They can give the meter.
RXZ if you mod like hell I tell you can go 160, 170.
That's why I like two strokes. I love the two stroke bike, you know. Of all the bikes I ride, I love the two strokes. Because it's very easy to maintain, it's cheap, and it has that
But the 2T must put the 2T leceh.
Okay, anyway, let's continue.
Okay, so next question we're gonna ask you. Okay, for yourself, is it practical for you as a daily driver?
Yes, I use this bike almost every day. There was only one point of time I never used for 5 days when I went to Langkawi. So I just park my bike here. That was the time I never ride. Other than that, every day I ride.
That one how? You leave it for 5 days, then when you come back, can restart or not? Or you need to warm it up?
Yeah, like. I restart, I just warm it up normally, then I just wait maybe.
You have to wait lah. No issues with the battery and everything.
Yeah, no issues.
New bike, of course. Nothing. You 5 days or so.
That point of time was December. So that time I parked for 5 days straight, it was only 1 month old, the bike.
New bike. New bike don't no problem. Imagine a 5-year-old bike.
You put there for 1 week.
The battery all gone already.
Okay, this one is a very important question. Everybody wants to know how is the fuel consumption like? How many liters? And is the full tank? And how far can it go?
The full tank I think is the highest I put was I think 8.8 liters, but I totally forgot how many liters it is. I think it's 10 or 12 .
Remember, you can just read the specs for
this. Yeah, read the specs. Google the specs .
Yeah. Then the last I checked before I put the petrol, it went up to 370 . 370.
Mm-hmm. Wow, then,
350 to 370. But most on average, I pump once a week. Yeah. Because I don't really pump a lot. Very gentle.
You usually use this for go to and
fro
and work?
I use this for work also.
What do you work?
Then for personal transportation also.
Okay, so far on your 9 months of owning the bike, any issues?
Actually, by right there shouldn't be any issues, but then due to some minor incidents such as some cars just make reckless turn which caused me to just jam brake, nest kick and fall. Just because of that, I had to change the parts all . Other than that, nothing much. And one thing I forgot to say just now. The very good thing about this bike, the stock tire size is 140. So when I went to change tire at one shop at Kaki Bukit, they didn't have Rosso 2. I was looking for Rosso 2. They didn't have the size 140. The mechanic told me he can try and fit size 160, but then he said only can try, but it's not confirmed. So he tried, and then this 160, now I'm using the 160, it actually fits. Wow. So I changed the tire to a bigger one. And I've never seen, actually class 2B, I've never seen a bike with size 160 tire before. I've seen only 150, maybe once or twice I got see 160, but quite rare.
That's why you say very weird though, class 2, the bike's getting smaller. But class 2B, the bike getting bigger. I really don't understand why the manufacturers are doing this.
If you have the opportunity to modify your bike, what would you want to change?
I think I've seen you make... I've seen the bike, generally you have made a few modifications. You've added in sliders, you change your throttle,
The grip.
Your grips.
Yeah, your wing, your what?
Mirror.
You have installed a windshield.
And then the winglet also.
You got winglet also.
Like Transformers, you
know. Kan? Macam Transformers, ya.
But the blue is not matching with this blue.
Never mind, you can wrap or paint or whatever, you know.
Actually, for the accessories wise, I've done quite like tail tidy, mud guard, the windshield, winglet, mirror, throttle. But other than that, like inside, like major, nothing. Even if I make modification, it's all like original due to the incident.
But then I see a lot of accessories for this bike, actually. Because the bike is available in Thailand, Malaysia.
They can bring it in. Or some people who ride the bike, they travel there to get the accessories.
So just now I actually suggested to Rasul earlier, you know, your bike you should ride to Thailand, then modify everything down there.
Yeah, modify and come back, but then cannot modify the bike.
It's okay.
Yeah, it's okay lah, but still okay lah.
Since you say that you have not faced any mechanical issues with your bike, so I'm sure you must have been into Facebook groups of the MT15. Is there any experiences or mechanical issue that you might heard of? Or they have shared on the Facebook page that you can tell share with the viewers?
I'm inside the MT15 group lah. I met them once, then I'm inside their WhatsApp group. But most of them ride the older version, which is the Saber. Saber M slash. So they face the issue which I'm...
But the engine is the same, right?
Okay, the Saber M slash is the same as R15 V2.
Okay.
Yeah, then this is the same as V3. Yeah. So mostly they face the issue is like due to like, you know, they use for quite some time. Yeah, that's why they face the issue. So maybe I'm not really sure what they face because sometimes inside the group are so many messages. So yeah, I just like take a glance then okay.
You know, when you want to buy a new bike, you definitely want to know what are the common issues because we have some viewers that actually left comments and they wanted to know about common issues and problems of the bikes that we review.
But I think for new bikes generally shouldn't have any issues lah.
Yeah.
Only after the first year, then usually the issues will start to come up.
Yeah.
I mean, but it's standard lah, it's a vehicle. So wear and tear definitely applies.
Yeah. Oh yes, there was only one time issue, my throttle cable came off.
Snap.
I was riding, then I was just throttling, then pop. Then after that, the throttle was like very... Then after that, I had no choice . I was near a car park entrance, so I just turned in, I stopped my bike. Then after that, I had to call the
tow.
That was the only issue, like out of nowhere, it occurred.
So Rasul, want to ask you, what's the best memory you have with the MT15? MT15.
The best memory I had was actually I didn't ride it to overseas yet because I'm not confident yet lah. Because I only ride around Singapore. Then with my friends who just recently passed his class 2B, he also bought a bike, but a second hand FZ. Four of us, all of us have bikes, so we just went to eat at East Coast Lagoon to have our dinner. It was on a weekend. Then after that, we just slowly ride back to Marina Barrage. And after that, we just enjoy the wind with our bikes. Then some photo shoots with the bike. And after that, we slowly ride back home because all of us stay around here. So from there, we together right here. So it felt like to everything there is a beginning. So now we just start riding in the expressway back home. Who knows in the future once we get our class 2 with a bigger bike, we'll hit the roads to overseas. Yeah, so that's a good memory with my friends. Whenever whenever I'm with my friends riding as a group, enjoying the slow pace with the wind, that is a very good thing I like.
Just a chill ride. The best feeling of being a rider is the wind blowing in your face.
Yes, that's what most people don't understand.
That's why most people don't understand the wind of the feeling of the wind blowing into your face, you know, as you ride.
Very cooling, especially at night after it rain. Very cooling.
Very cooling, like aircon like that.
And especially and when the road is really clear, you know, you don't want to ride fast, you know. Just want to ride, relax. You just want to enjoy the road.
That's what I really love.
Do you think the MT15 is a suitable bike for newbie riders?
Honestly, it's actually for me, I don't think so. Because the bike is quite high. And for me, I'm slightly, my legs are long so I can reach the ground, so it's okay for me. Like, I can just anything, I can just put my feet down. And then, it's also a quite slightly aggressive for me, like, as compared to other bikes I ride. Very responsive. So, but actually, beginners can get, like, if they are into, like, they are really into big bikes, they can get this bike, then they can get the kick of it, lah. Like, it's really, if you're into aggressive bike, lah.
Maybe those class 2B newbies can try like what you did lah. You know, try brand a few bikes before they actually made a decision.
But before I got this bike, I never tried this bike. Only I tried the R15 V3. Also similar to this, but I'm not into a sports bike.
Okay, the most importantly, if you want to buy a bike, just stick to what you like lah. If you like it, then buy it. Don't listen to other people. Don't care what people say. Okay lah guys, so we're going to finish this vlog here. Thank you Rasul for sharing your machine, your story with us. And hope, you know, for you to follow us one day to Johor.
Surely we'd love to go more further.
And hopefully Thailand. Okay guys, that's it for the vlog. And hope you like the review. And yes, we will see you in the next one.